Hey, how you doing? It's Emilio here. This video is brought to you by Moonlock, where we do cybersecurity software for humans. And in this video, we're going to be talking to you about how can you hide your IP address. Before we do get into that, please do remember to, as always, click on that subscription button and on the bell so that you don't miss out on anything. Now, let's give you a bit of a summary introduction before we get into the topic specifically. Now, when you're on the internet, you have got a IP address that is being shown to the world. This is essentially your public IP address, a unique IP address that is assigned to your network, your home network, by generally your service provider. So this means that your network is not completely private. It's not hidden. So what then happens is that your internet traffic is potentially exposed. So when you're surfing on the internet, it's not completely anonymous. Go onto your Google and type in, what is my IP address? You'll see your IP address right over there. Other people can do the same thing. So what are a few things that you can do to essentially hide or mask your IP address? What we want to do is we want to be able to trick the bad guys into actually thinking that you're somewhere else in a different location than where you actually are. One of the easiest ways that you can do this is by using a VPN, a virtual private network, where essentially you can encrypt your traffic. So all of your web traffic now flows through this VPN. And what the VPN will do, essentially will mask or hide your IP address to make it appear as if it's coming from somewhere else. So if somebody wants to try to interact with you, you're not actually based in the country that you actually are. You could be based in a different country. You can actually set the VPN to connect from somewhere else. Another great way that you can hide your IP address is by using a proxy. Essentially, this could be a proxy server that you set up or that you establish with a company. So all the traffic essentially flows through this new proxy and essentially hides your IP address. To set this up, go into the system settings on your Mac and go to the network spot. You can do this over your Wi-Fi or over Ethernet. I'm connected to Wi-Fi, so I'm gonna go into there, selecting details. I then go down to the proxies area. Now here, there's various options. If your network is set up with a proxy, it should hopefully detect it automatically. Otherwise, you can manually set a proxy, setting the IP address, setting the host name, or setting the port. Once the proxy is done, go and check out your IP address, your public IP address, again through a browser. It should now be updated, masking your original IP. If you're at home, if you're using your own internet connection, then your home network has an IP address. But if you connect to a different network, then that IP address is now different. So that could be, you've got your phone. I've got a phone. You can actually go and set up a personal hotspot from your phone. So then now your computer connects to the Wi-Fi that is being displayed through the personal hotspot created by your phone. Essentially then, it's now got a new IP address through your phone provider. Another way would be to connect to a public Wi-Fi. So if you're in a location, you're in a shopping center, you're in a restaurant, there is a Wi-Fi available there. By you connecting to that, you're not going to be displaying your IP address anymore, you're going to be displaying that IP address.
You still do have a public IP, but this is now different because it is being provided by a different provider. Either the telecommunications company giving your IP address to your phone, or the public Wi-Fi, perhaps the IP address that is being used by that shopping center. So now you can browse more anonymously.
And then finally, something that you can always do is if you are wanting to be protected from your ISP provided IP address, ask them to change it for you. There are some services where you can actually be assigned a static IP, allowing you to maybe log into the website of your service provider and you manually changing your IP address. And then this way, if you have the ability to have your ISP changing it for you or you changing it, then your IP can always change. You could go and surf online, change it when you need it, and then surf online again. There are a few ways to mask or hide your IP address, but of course, if you do want to remain even more protected, it's always good when you're on the internet that you are browsing in private browsing mode and always clearing out your cache or your cache to make sure that your history and your tracking information is clean. Remember to give it a thumbs up if you did like this video, and also remember to click on the subscription button on the bell so that you don't miss out on any of our video releases. Thanks again for tuning in. We'll see you on the next video.